All right, so it's the 111 days, Brooke Cooper and Willie Carter. 111 days now that our baby was killed in the middle of I-10 in Biloxi. Shot. That child was surrounded by law enforcement, and as of yet, we still don't know who shot little Lamar LaMelo Parker. We don't have a clue. I know there's some movement here locally, and John, I'm going to give you a call here shortly regarding some GoFundMe, but we need to chat first. And of course, needless to say, there is a lot of behind the scenes happening right now from many organizations, not to mention the NAACP and others. It is true that the FBI is looking into ballistics, but however, we've not gotten a confirmation that they are investigating the civil rights violation of one LaMelo Parker. I'm reading as I'm talking, pardon me. So, we will be vigilant, and I'm sure that there are others who will be. The Biloxi PD is still doing the investigation. They still have not informed us. We thought it was forthcoming that they turned it over to the district attorney. But I do know that there's some movement. I do know that. I've talked to the commissioner. Public Safety Commissioner, Sean Tindall, and I do know that there is, on the part of the state troopers and the state police, there are serious concerns about what happened that day. And there's always concerns. The greatest concern whenever you have a multi-jurisdictional event is who's in charge. We, just peasants here in this great state, always think that someone's always in charge. They're cross jurisdiction, blah, blah, blah. Someone's got to be in charge. Is it the sheriff? Is the public safety commissioner? Is it the chief of police? Who's in charge? Well, ladies and gentlemen, we need to get that together, and we need to help law enforcement get that together, and the legislature needs to help law enforcement get that together by simply saying, here is how this works. Or else we're going to get a lot of people killed, including police officers. Anything could have happened that day, bro. 30-some-odd shots go off into a vehicle. Trust me on this, ladies and gentlemen. I know a little bit about firearms, and once you pull that trigger, Your decision is gone. You know what you aimed at, but that slug is going to go anywhere it wants to go. It'll hit, it'll ricochet, it'll go anywhere it wants to go. And there's no my bad when it comes down to firearms. I'm just going to tell you that. Excuse me. Now I want you to listen to me. I heard a very gruesome thing last night. I'm not saying it to scare you. I'm saying it because it is very, very true. I had a local mortician to tell me that yesterday, before 6 p.m., that mortician was called to a local hospital to pick up 5 bodies as a result of COVID. 5 bodies. And none of those bodies were over 55 years old. This is serious. Rip Daniels has no doubt that he will get COVID. You might as well say it. It's not if, it's when. Rip Daniels, however, understood based upon that he's got to decide how sick he will be. He's got to come up with some way to prohibit me from being deathly ill. That is the reason for why Rip Daniels chose to get the Johnson & Johnson vaccine. Particularly after hearing and seeing one of my own blood become seriously sick for 14 days. It's not a matter of whether I'm gonna die, it's a matter of whether I wanna be that sick. Can I afford to be that sick? I got people depending on me, I got stuff I gotta do. I hate being sick. Man, if I get sick, better leave me alone. I told you before, when I get sick, I'm like an old hound dog that goes up under the porch and licks his paw until he gets better. And if you look up under that porch at me while I'm licking my paw until I get better, I'm going to growl at you. I have to heal myself. God, I hate being sick. I do. So I got the vaccine. When I heard that from the mortician, I was shocked. Because we really think that it's not. I'm healthy, wealthy, feeling good. But it's not if now, ladies and gentlemen. It is when you get sick. And you need to plan for when you get sick. Now, you can sit there, you can believe whatever you want to believe, all the conspiracy theories, all that old bull crap, all you want. But the truth is, it's not if. It's when. I've been vaccinated. I'm accepting that more than likely I will get COVID. Now, it's not usual. However, this new strand, the Johnson & Johnson's Moderna or Pfizer, is not resistant to that. Well, it's resistant, but it's not foolproof. There's nothing foolproof in medicine anyway, folks. It's a practice, for God's sake. Works on this person, doesn't work on that person. Stop thinking like these dumbass conservatives out here who feel that there's absolutism, that, oh, yeah, well, you said it wouldn't. You said if I wear a mask, I wouldn't get it. I wore a mask. I got it. How juvenile is that? These are all preventions, ladies and gentlemen. Ounce of prevention is worth a pound of cure. It doesn't mean that you won't get it. Five bodies he picked up, bro. Does that startle you?
Yeah.
In a day. Do you have my numbers here? I don't have my numbers in here. But in the last 2 weeks, 2.5 weeks, We're rounding 60,000 new cases of COVID in this state. All the time while now, according to Jerry Mitchell, I've got it right here. This study now that shows that Mississippi leads the nation per capita again in diabetes deaths. How about that? Is it COVID? Is it diabetes? They're building another field hospital. They're out of beds, bro. And not only out of beds, but out of staff to maintain the beds. Who wants to argue with this? I don't want to argue with it. It is not if. It is when you get COVID. And if you want to do the gamble and you'll survive it, you'll be okay. You can do that. Just ask some of those who had it that and recover, whether or not it's a picnic in the park. The other thing is, your chances. I know that now, for Rip Daniels, there is a 74% chance that I'm going to get COVID. And it's not because of, I stay away from folks. I wear my bandana. Contrary to what you might believe, I don't get around a lot of folks. And I'm not in closed places. I get a whole lot of sunlight and I eat well. However, just the sheer numbers of the people you know have it or have had it should tell you that you're going to, if you have bumped into at least five people that you know have either have it or had it, more than likely your turn is coming. it's just kind of commonsensical for me. Okay, he had it. How many we had here? Yeah, 1, 2, 3. Had about 6. Just in this little small business. Okay. Then it's, I'm sure bet that somewhere down the line, what are you going to do about it? Is the question. Now, for those of you who want to bring up whatever your explanation is for not getting it and so forth, I'll offer you some time. It's okay. My compliments to Luann at Scarlet Pearl. She is requiring her staffers to, in fact, get a vaccination. I saw a young lady on who didn't want to take it, and she's going to leave the Scarlet Pearl. Okay. That is your prerogative. We don't have to argue about it. We really don't. If at a time when I was not convinced, I wouldn't fly a plane. In other words, there were places that things I wanted to do and could do and should do, like go fly to Massachusetts and check out the Moors. Got an update on them, by the way. Then I couldn't do that because they were requiring that I get a vaccination. I mean, I'd said that I would take a test 2 days before, but that wasn't good enough, so okay, fine. There are things you can't do. If you're 16 years old, you can't go in and you can't go buy vodka legally. There are limits that we can do. I mean, it is what government does. It says, okay, for the good of the whole, it is not wise for another 16-year-old to go in and buy vodka. Same thing is true of masks. Just incomprehensible how we have, how we have just gotten to the point whereby it's like, you know, what you have are very loud people shouting down individuals who are offering common sense and saying, well, we need to mandate masks. Now, if you have an exception, if your child has a stuffy nose and he can't wear a mask and can't breathe, then get a permission slip. But the rest of everybody else is going to wear a mask. Okay. In other words, what you get from conservatives is, it's either my way or the highway. Instead of, you know, what's good for the whole? Well, let's see, masks would be far more effective. We've proven that because we, you know, we had school. We've had them in school, and they wore masks, and guess what? It was effective. Okay, so that's what we'll require, masks. And if, in fact, you have some reason why you can't, do you know that when I was in school, there were these chubby fellows, real whiny boys. He used to always wonder why they didn't go out for football. But anyway, most of them lived in Bible View. They got a permission slip to wear their shirt tail out of their pants because they were heavy. And it made them hard. You know, but it's okay, it's their prerogative. Some of the same individuals, usually from Bible View, also got permission to smoke. And they were only 16 years old. True story. I know you shocked when I said that before, but that's true story. If you were going to Gulfport East or Gulfport High, I know Gulfport East for sure, in and around 70, you were able to smoke if you wanted to smoke. If your parents gave you permission, you went in between the cafeteria and the theater and you were able to smoke. Cool boys were a little bit, well, they thought they were cool. It's getting worse, Mississippi. It's getting worse, and the sad thing is that we do not have individuals who are acting like government is supposed to act. You see, government promotes the general welfare. I mean, of course, that's in the Constitution and the preamble. But there's no promotion of that now. Now there's promotion of only my politics. There is no reasonable explanation as to why Dictator Reeves cannot look back at the numbers and see when we straightened the curve and when we started to have fewer COVID deaths and infections. There's no reason why, explanation why him and Dobbs, notice I didn't say doctor, are not saying, hey, look, here is how we stopped the flood of hospitalizations in July last year, in August. This is how we stopped it. And you do that again. I'm just a backyard carpenter, folks, and I'm going to tell you something. I don't argue with my Stanley ruler or my Stanley circular saw.
Stanley, good brand.
That's Obama's mama's name. I don't argue with it when what was wrong with you, saw? What's wrong with you, ruler? Didn't you measure twice and cut once? What's wrong with y'all? It's just dumb. Can I cut it wrong? Yeah. Can I measure wrong? Yeah. Depends on which end. You got the smart end of the ruler and the dumb end of the ruler. Now, if you don't know how to read the ruler, then you're on the dumb end. Pretty simple. But it's like we're having to sit here and listen to individuals who we know are dumb as a brick. There's no way in the world Dictator can explain to a mother who has just got a sick child. There's no way you can explain to her that it's okay, that it's about, well, okay, yeah, you know, you didn't have to wear a mask. When anytime you go into the hospital, ladies and gentlemen, and someone comes into your room and you've got a contagious disease, they're wearing a damn mask. And I don't mean an N95 all the time. It's just dumb. Then you got doctors who argue, well, the masks are not effective, and these are the very same ones who are wearing a mask when they come see you. Get a fungus on your foot and then go in there and see if they don't wear a mask. Go to your dentist and see if he's not wearing a mask. I mean, come on. It's just...
Well, they're not effective. They're just not effective. That's all. They're just not effective, man.
They just don't work.
And then now, ladies and gentlemen, there was yet another study that shows that your toddlers could really actually carry more of the disease than others. Well, you know, the kids are germy little rascals. They really are. Just as cute as they could be. But everything on the floor goes in their mouth. Anything else goes in their mouth. I mean, that's just how it is. I'm trying to find that study here. Where is it? I'll find it. Oh, here, just babies. Babies more likely than teenagers to transmit a virus.
Wow.
You didn't know that, did you? While parents pay extra attention to their school-age children, health experts said they shouldn't let their guards down when it comes down to those toddlers and the babies. A study published Monday in the JAMA Pediatrics suggests that they're more likely than teens to transmit the virus to other members of the household because you're holding them, you're cuddling them. Oh my God, there's nothing better than picking up that little baby and hold them close under your chin and you feel their little hand pat you on the back as if to say, God, I just love you so much. Their breath smells like bananas all the time. Don't you just love them? Cuddly. They'll smile and you didn't have to teach them. God did that. And they are so defensive. All they can do is sit there and be germy little rascals. Give it to you. And you'll gladly take it because it's enduring. Give me your cold. Give me your COVID. I'd rather me have it than you would have it because, ladies and gentlemen, parents like yours truly understand that there's nothing more helpless, oh God, than a sick child. And nothing makes you feel more helpless. You ask yourself, how is it that God could allow this poor baby to be this sick? This sick? What did he or she do to deserve this? Someone gave it to me. That could very well be you. Just simply because you didn't wear a mask and didn't take a shot. What's wrong with you? Don't tell me you love somebody and somehow or another go, okay, yeah, well, I might have it, but I don't believe it's the government. The government's making us do this. And then you end up with a sick baby. Do you know it's the pediatrics? I mean, that ICU is full. And then there's that syndrome. Now, I don't know. Researchers from Public Health Ontario, a Canadian public health agency, looked at 6,280 households with sick children from June to December 2020, grouping them into four age categories. And what did they find, you ask? I'll tell you what they found. They found that those little children are big spreaders. And the disease becomes more virulent inside those little babies. How many schools now shut down? What's wrong with you? You know, we've got to be, I don't know what is it that has forced us to forget what works, what doesn't work. I mean, what is it going to take? Well, we're going to shut down the schools now, Virgil. I understand one of the school board members, I think Barbara Thomas, Dr. Thomas, sent information. Now the county school, one county school now is shutting down, giving some options. You can either go virtual, you can go this. You had to end up passing out COVID, not grades, to get to this point. How dumb are y'all? It's just dumb. Why take the chance? However, ladies and gentlemen, there is now at least one agency who's been listening to Rip Daniels, Dr. Paul Byers. Dr. Paul Byers saw that some 800 Mississippi schools are reporting COVID outbreaks, 20,000 students statewide under quarantine. Oh my God. So Dr. Byers, the epidemiologist at the state health department, came up with a ingenious idea. Guess what he's now suggesting, Ro?
What's that?
Test. Weekly. The boy, it's about time, don't you think? Ah, yeah. However, the schools can opt into this. They can opt into weekly rapid testing for asymptomatic students and for the staff. That's weekly. Or, particularly staff who are unvaccinated. And the tests are going to be provided by the Mississippi Department of Health. How about that? You guys see that yet? That is how we do this. You see, it's sort of like, you know, you have to figure out what the lice is and find out what kid has the lice, and then you tell that kid he got to go home. You got to wash your hair, boy. I mean, this is how you stop a spread. First, you got to find out who has it. Now, of course, you can see the lice in some cases. Other cases, you can't. Some people have some thicker hair. If you're an African-American and got an afro, you don't have to worry about that. I don't know why lice don't like our hair. You think it's discrimination, Ro? Mm-hmm. You know, I can remember when I went to integrated school and they had this outbreak at East Junior High, and all the kids, they got an opportunity to go home. You know, why they got to go home? They have lice. I thought to myself, that's a ticket out of here. I didn't want to be sitting in there doing algebra. So you get lice, you go home? I ought to get that, huh? To which the teacher responded, you can't get lice. Oh, I want you to know, ladies and gentlemen, as a proud black man, I was going, why not? Chucky's got lice. Why can't I have it? Are you holding back? I'm sorry, Daniels. You can't get lice. You can't go home. What, they just went home? Susan's gone. Chucky's gone. You've got Brad's gone. Dick's gone. I don't know why they called him that. His name is Richard.
But the voice had already changed at that point, even though it's first grade. So it was like, why can't I get light?
They were holding back on me, bro.
Where's that? Where the light?
I'm the only one in the classroom.
Oh, I can't get light, huh? My hair blonde, too. What's up?
Only black man in that classroom, and I had to sit in there. And listen to me. I had to sit in there and not raise my hand because my teacher chose not to call on me. Did I ever tell you the story?
Maybe, but...
Miss Smith, she chose not to call on me. I would raise my hand because I was a participant. She'd raise my hand and wouldn't call on me. Not only did I not get lice, she would not call on me. I went and I told my father about it. And let me just tell you, African-American parents will never, ever... never ever make their children feel insecure. They're always gonna prop up our self-esteem. I never once thought I was a second-class student. Ever, never. And that was to the surprise of many of my Caucasian counterparts. So I went to my dad and said, Dad, you know, she never wanted to give me more than a C. I earned more than a C, but she ain't gonna give it to me. First year of integration. So my dad said, you gotta have some school participation. So I raised my hand. She wouldn't call me, never call on me. Went to my dad said, well, son, she won't call on you? No. Well, it says here that you're not participating. I am participating. She don't call me, Dad. Well, I would say participating is just simply raise your hand, right? Yes, sir. Well, then, raise your hand. Ain't your fault she doesn't call on you. So half of the class, I stand like this. Sometimes I be like this. Just like that. I always kept my hand up. I did. That made me feel good, too. Because after all, I had something to say. I've always got something to say. And it wasn't, I was participating. She just didn't allow me to. I walked out of the classroom every day with my head up. She'd ask a question, and knowing that all the Caucasian kids would hold their hands up, my hand was up. She just didn't call them. I felt like dumbass kids. But I knew, and it didn't matter that she didn't call on me because I knew, and she knew I knew. Boy, I like coming here. You didn't see that in the script, did you?
I did not.
So now Dr. Byers is suggesting that the schools can opt in with rapid tests once a week for those individuals who are asymptomatic. You send your kid to school, it's not the kind that they're not gonna reach in and pull their brain out with that, and it's not like that. These are the least painful, maybe? You've had the rapid test, bro. So have I. They're very, very easy. You go in, just do a little swab, map it on the top of your nose, or maybe your throat. You've done the throat one, right?
Yeah.
Actually, they had them. They were offering them to the staff there at Gulfport way back when, and they were very effective. Now, don't get me wrong. They're not FDA approved, and the efficacy of them, whether they're effective, is questionable. I mean, you're 75, 80, 90%. Who's to say for sure because they're not FDA approved? However, this is the way to do it, don't you think?
And I just heard from Kemp, he's busy painting down there, he's Biloxi, but he says his youngest son in Germany, they're testing there at his school 3 times a week.
Yeah, that's the way to do it. Find out who has it, and because you need to know. And then that person gets quarantined, like you do someone with lice. Universal wearing of masks, he recommends. Social distancing, 3 feet apart in the classroom, 6 feet outside, or maybe in the hallways. Makes sense. So now, do you think they're going to do it? Dictator Reeves says, hell no. He's not going to mandate it. He ain't going to mandate it. Read my lips.
That's pretty good.
Well, I can't read your lips. You got a mask on.
Well, yeah.
Well, take your mask off so I can read your damn lips. You don't want to around me.
No.
Well, why?
Well, you know, you've seen your nostrils.
What is my... So you've noticed the extra muscle. I mean, we are pretty powerful people. I mean, we've got that Negro natal thing going. You can't do this, can you?
I don't think so.
Can you see that?
I
can. See, I'm working on that. That's not Samantha on Bewitched. She twinkles her nose. See, African Americans have these extra muscles right along here. This is why the mask stays on us. It flattens out just right. And I'm not saying it inside. I mean, but we are different. The culture, I mean, there's multiculturalism in one of the cultures. Is it like this? Because, yeah, I got the nostrils. So what? So you don't. And what? What does that have to do with anything, dictator? So if you have your mask down and I've got these nostrils, what, I inhale and you suffocate? Is that what you're trying to suggest?
I mean, I'll fly across the room. I don't know.
Fly across the room.
As possible, and make sure that the parents of the students at this state can make the right decisions, the informed decision for their own children, and not be dictated to.
Dictated to? Oh, you just threw that in there, didn't you?
And went with the other thing and made a new thing.
You know, I get that there's some masculinity in your voice somewhere, man.
Well, it's on the road.
Well, I know, but you can't. You say you don't have an Adam's apple, because I can tell. It's kind of, you know, you've got that triple chin thing going. But look, I'm not. I mean, since you talked about my nose, I mean, I gotta get something in, wrong, wouldn't you say?
Oh, well, I mean.
Well, I guess is that a navel?
That's generally.
Oh, that's not your. That is your navel. That is not your Adam's apple.
Or Jenkin, if you're from Stone.
Jenkin, what did you know about that, dictator? I hate it when you put those cheeks on. I'm gonna turn the camera over there so they can see those jowls. You've been around, so yeah. You been in the hood, have you?
No.
You're in the hood. You're in Jackson, for God's sake. Where do you think the governor's mansion is?
Just on the outskirts.
Oh, just on the edge. We're right there. You're on Capitol Street. You're right downtown. Come out at night and see what happens. And see, aren't you in the hood?
I don't.
You'll bump into Cap Man, and he'll probably have to get you a cab. Do you know Cap Man, by the way?
I don't. I'd like to meet him, though. Sounds like a smart man.
Would you ride in his cab?
I would.
Yeah, well, he's going to require you to wear a mask.
Oh, well, then no.
He'll sell you what? Oh, God, I hate you. Well, I tell you, I got a whole show to do here. I got to get very serious again.
Yeah, we've only got 33 minutes
here. Jesus, please. That is your navel, not your Adam's apple, I guess. And then there's those of you who somehow or another feel that it's a catastrophe going on right now at the air base in Afghanistan. Not one American dead. And mostly what I see, ladies and gentlemen, are a bunch of, let's see, military-age Afghans trying to jump on a damn plane. Whatever happened to women and children first? I mean, look, I know some, I've not been there. Some of you guys had interpreters, I got you. They were helping the American forces out of patriotism. They want to save their country. Well, guess what? We left. It's still your country. Stay your butt there and do exactly what the insurgents did in Iraq. Or ISIS. I mean, well, you just got to fight us. You think guerrilla warfare is only designed to fight Americans? Who are women or children? I mean, it just makes me wonder, well, what happened to all the guns? 300,000 guns are somewhere. And we didn't have the AKs that I saw in the Taliban hands. I mean, they had, I'm telling you, we had the creme de la creme. What is the upscale M16 now? What is it called? It's called something else.
The import?
I don't know. Whatever it was, they have them. Have them. Or at least Taliban got them. I mean, it's not like these guys walking around with body armor. Here you have thousands of people. Thousands of men in long dresses. Well, they're not long dresses. Whatever they are. Smocks. I don't know. Running and trying to jump on a plane. They would just assume risk flying on the belly of a C-17. Then taking out a Taliban? I mean, come on. I mean, it's not like these guys running around in Humvees. They're on Toyota Tacomas, for God's sake. Man, you can flatten a tire, bro. What happened to IEDs? I mean, come on, you guys gotta, you know. We're gonna get into it. I saw Joe Biden with Stephanopoulos, and I was very impressed. Very impressed. And he was pressured. And it's so hard, I think, for the Dog Network to really come out and criticize Joe outside of saying his cognitive skills, because what the man is saying is accurate. Is that, guess what? We're not going to risk another life. We're not. He knows the Powell Doctrine. By the way, Powell wrote this doctrine after serving in Vietnam. Know what it says? And by the way, he had returned as a general. It says this. There are times when American lives must be risked and lost. Foreign policy cannot be paralyzed by the prospect of casualties, but lives must not be risked until we can face a parent or a spouse or a child with a clear answer to the question of why a member of that family had to die. To provide a symbol or a presence is not good enough. Women and children first. If you can tell the gun, stay your butt there in Afghanistan and fight for that country. We'll be back.
COVID cases are rising. Remember, the more...